Rafi Glick, Independent Analyst on Space Policy and Geopolitical Trends. Rafi, thanks for being here with us in Negocios TV. It's a pleasure having you here. Thank you so much.
Nice to meet you, nice to have you with you.
We are talking about three agendas, talking about this exercise by the UN. What is the planetary defense exercise, and has the UN confirmed this case?
Look, the UN planned this exercise probably a long time ago, but since middle or 23rd of October, they decided to join Sri Atlas to this exercise, because Sri Atlas was a real target to follow and should be operated by all telescopes and the spacecraft all over the universe. So they decided to combine the exercise with this comet. And about a few weeks ago, I got hints from ESA and from NASA that something going on. And I decided to elaborate. Now, the steering committee of UN, of this organization, is actually forced by or under the influence of NASA and ESA. The other three people are permanent working there. So ESA and NASA are a main factor in this organization. And then officially, you know, the world was was quiet, and they were very silent, only hints and some here and there, some news on the network. So I decided to, I found the right link to the exercise. And since nobody published it before, and I had many comments that people asked me, what's going on? There is no exercise, nothing happened. So I decided on Monday evening to publish the official documents. So that's what's going on now. Now it's published all over.
Waiting for more info about this three Atlas. Do you understand the controversy surrounding three Atlas?
Look, three Atlas is a strange and mystery neighbor in our area. It's come from the outside of the solar system, and it's here since July, so almost 5 months. And although the majority say it is a natural comet and the minority don't agree, not always the majority is right and the minority is wrong. So as Einstein said, okay, whenever you try, you should get on the same example, you should get the same result. Whenever you get one which is wrong, it's not the theory, it's not working. So I believe in an investigation and in research, in a science, in an evidence. So I, even the majority say it's, even NASA and also ESA say it's no threat and it's a natural comet, I think we should continue to investigate, to elaborate all opinions. And this is the mission of science.
Rafi, talking about these opinions, I would like to ask you about A.B. Loeb. What do you think of A.B. Loeb's theories?
A.B. Loeb, I know him very well. He's a great scientist, and he believes in investigate all kind of anomalies and all kind of strange. And everything should be based on evidence. And whenever there is not 100% evidence for natural comet, he thinks that should be elaborated and investigated. And actually, I agree with his method. Of course, there is some, it should be published or it should be pressed with a kind of balance, but I agree with his method. And one of the lake or the, let's say, the, what they missed in this exercise, there is no kind of a social science behind it or around it or with it that take care also to the public behave and to communication and to explanations of all kind of issues. So there is a lot of rumors and some panics and many questions, and that's something that's better to be take care. But with this kind of comet, which they said it harmless, then maybe in the future, which will be a different issue. Also, you know, this issue of Sri Atlas moved from the science. When I started to follow it, let's say five months ago, it was only on the science papers. Now it's on the TikTok with Kim Kardashian and with Elon Musk and all those kind. And even today it's published in a newspaper of a city, small city in Israel, or even in Spain by a football team. So this kind, it's moved from the science to the people. So, you know, the organizer and also the institutions and also the agencies should take care for it. And what happened that I should, in my blog and in my articles, I should answer people which are worried about the situation and they have questions and nobody could address it.
The last question, Rafi. We saw the last week the explanations by the NASA. Do you trust in the NASA, the ESA? Do you trust them?
I trust NASA and I trust ESA. But I think they should explain everything to the public, as you know, in high school or as at this first year of students. So they cannot get the situation as fully understood by the public. They should follow. For example, now there is a lot of newspaper and a lot of news about ESA and what happened yesterday with their minister of council and also with the planetary defense issue all over the world. The only place where is quiet is the US press. And I have a question, why? And also the organization are a little bit quiet, although today was some press by ESA, but not direct press. So I think they should change their attitude. They should take care for the public. They should take care for transparency, you know. When it was a Blair photo during the Mars mission in October, some people think it was a UFO. There is an organization that's under NASA and under the Department of Defense in the United States. They promised to the public transparency. So we cannot wait until the annual report. Well, maybe it will be a year from now, maybe 6 months from now. So this is something they should change the attitude. I trust them. They have the best scientists. They are doing a great job, all of them. But they should take also for the public for taking care for the public interest.
Well, waiting for more info about Sri Atlas, waiting for the 19th of December, his pass about the land. Rafi, thanks for being with us in Negocios TV. It's a pleasure having you here. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Rafi. Good day.